here, and the serving is from 4 to 6. If you wanted to help, you can come early, and if you wanted to help clean up, you can stay. So then next Sunday, the worship service, Bishop Laura Bardens is going to be here, and she is going to be giving a sermon. But Pastor said he's also going to be here. So regarding Sunday school, I, not this church, but I kind of grew up going to Sunday school because I'm on campus. So I was there probably from the nursery on up until I graduated from high school, and then I went away. So, you know, that was kind of like what instilled in me what we're here for, you know, what we're supposed to be doing and learning and believing. So I highly recommend to have your kids in Sunday school and or go to the adult Sunday school with your son. Okay, now prepare for worship.
Steadfast and faithful God,
you never reveal the ways of justice, yet we fail to follow you. We are overwhelmed by the world's violence and suffering. We are afraid to risk what we have for the sake of others. For the harm you have caused, known and unknown, forgive us. For the unjust demands we place on others and your creation,
are always
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Cassandra was the daughter in mythology, the daughter He had 50 children, she was one of them, and she loved the temple. So she would be drawn to the temple. And when she was young, she went to the temple, and she was there so long that it turned into night, and she spent the night in there. And she fell asleep inside the temple, and the gods saw her, and were so impressed with her love for the temple and for all of this stuff, that they gave her the ability to prophesy. So do you know what prophesying means? It's the ability not just to talk to another person, but maybe lots of other people about truth, to tell them something like a warning, or to be able to tell them where God might be at work, or the gods might be at work in the world around them. And so she had this gift because she loved the temple. And it wasn't much longer after that in Greek mythology that Apollo turned his eye towards her. Have you ever heard of Apollo? I don't know what the deal with Greek mythology is, but Apollo in Greek mythology always has an eye for the ladies, and he's always being spurned by them. This is like every story in Greek mythology starts this way, or has this in it. And this happened with Cassandra, and Apollo was very angry because Cassandra was not interested. Cassandra was interested in the things of the temple, but not Apollo. So Apollo could not take her gift of prophecy from her. And again, prophecy is the ability to tell words to people that are meaningful, to warn them, to give them sort of hope, eternal life. She had this ability. He could not take this from her, but he did curse her. And so if you know mythology, you know the curse is Cassandra. If not, you're up on what it is. He could not take this skill from her, but he made it so that even though she had the gift of prophecy, no one would ever believe ever anything she'd ever said. So for example, she warns Troy not to take that big giant wooden horse into it because it was all going to end in disaster. Cassandra warned them not to do that because she had the gift to see what would happen. But she'd been cursed by Apollo. Nobody listened. They took the thing in, and you know the whole story coming. Today is God's Work, Our Hands Sunday. Are you aware of this? Do you know this? So this is the 10th year for that. This is the 10th anniversary. As part of the ELCA, the Evangelical Lutheran Church of America, St. Stephen participates in God's Work, Our Hands Sunday. And I tell this joke every time, and I don't even know if it's that funny, but it bothers me every time. And I like that some of you have these shirts on today, but it bothers me that they always do this on the first Sunday of the NFL season, and it's Steelers colors, and I don't know why they've done that. And some of you, like, I'm glad you got the shirts on, but part of me is like, I don't know what I think about these shirts. But today is God's Work, Our Hands Sunday. And we've been doing this. Churches in the LCA throughout the country participate today with God's Work, Our Hands. And it's 10 years of this. It's become sort of a pretty successful big deal in our church together. And I'm thinking about that and that story about Cassandra that I told you a second ago, a minute ago. Right? I feel like we know who God is, and I feel like we know where the world is at. And the Holy Spirit breathes into us these words that would offer hope and justice and abundant life to people. But I think a lot of people feel like they've already heard it, right? Oh, that Jesus guy, you're just one of those people, and you're telling me something I already heard. And so I can kind of identify with Cassandra a little bit. That we have these words that would be words of warning or words of eternal life, and that we live in this world where people will say, oh, I've already heard that, I don't know. You know, think about your grandkids or your kids or your neighbors or people at work or school or whatever, if you try to proclaim the gospel and how that feels, right? You've been there? It feels like people are just kind of like, that might mean something, but it sort of falls on deaf ears. So to me, this is what God's Work, Our Hands Sunday is about. That if people are feeling like assuming that the words of God that we have, like God's gifts to proclaim, are already heard and they don't need to hear them, then maybe we can try something different. Maybe instead of speaking, we use our gifts work. But I feel like a sinner sometimes. Like, everybody's, I've already heard that. I don't know if people hear it for real, right? God's work hour begins. Sunday is a day that we're called together and to think maybe less about how we can talk about who God is and more how we can show it through who we've been made in Christ. So today, the service should be a little shorter, it's going to go a little quicker. And at the end of the service, instead of just me talking, you know, more words out there, and instead of me telling you things about Greek mythology that you may or may not care about, we are going to, together, do at least two things. And if you have an idea that you'd like to try, you can try that too, but we'll offer two things. The first thing, we do this every year on God's Work Hour on Sunday, take the time between when we get out and before the Browns game. Do not watch the Steelers game, only the Browns game, or whatever you're doing this afternoon. Take the time between the end of church and that to shop for the pantry. We'll have a list for you of things that would be work well for the pantry. And while you're doing that, we're thinking about how our actions are a proclamation that the world doesn't have to be filled with as much badness as we feel like it is. But we pull out hope. And we do that because of who Christ made us, and we can shop for the pantry. So that's one option. You can take that list when you leave here and do that today. The other option is we have a couple of people who will guide us through making greeting cards, our own handmade greeting cards. And we will have a list of people that, through St. Stephen, you could send those to, but you don't have to send those to those people. You could also think of someone who you've been trying to be prayerful for, or share words of the gospel to, at work or wherever. And you can use that card to just say, I'm thinking of you, or happy birthday, or however you feel led to use that. And so those are two options when we leave here. You can shop at the pantry. If you're going to make cards, we're going to do that down the hall in the fellowship hall. Or if you have some other idea of how you've been gifted and your gifts could speak in the world that we live in a way that people will hear, that it would feel fulfilling for you to speak that way, not just words, but your hands and what God has given you. This is who we'll be, and this is how we'll venture into this day. So in a few moments, we're still going to commune together. This is a reminder of God's word, but it's a reminder of God's presence in this place, in bread and wine, and that this presence is for us. And we hold out faith that even where our words might feel like people don't know what to make of them, our actions can be filled with the Spirit too. And those actions can make a difference, can be God's difference for ourselves and for others. So you'll have a couple of options. You can pray about which one of those works for you. We'll commune and then do those together today. Amen.
Thank you. caring and generous work of God, we pray for the church, creation, and the needs of our neighbors. Hold us accountable, O God. Show your church where repentance is needed and lead us in paths of intentional compassion and listening.
Help us to stand in the hands of reconciliation and care, especially in relationships with other Christians and people of other faiths.
Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Reveal your miracles to us, O God. Move us to cherish you as we behold the wonders of creation. Renew the seas and the soil, the forests and the creatures that live in them.
Turn us to ways of living that seems first crying.
Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Inspire us to lead with honor, O God. Guide judges and legislatures, police and government officials, to create and uphold just laws.
Move us to treat all people with dignity and guide our conversations with one another.
Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Help us comfort those who suffer, O God. Reassure any who are harmed by the wicked acts of others. Bring peace to all who are vulnerable, frightened, despairing, or sick, especially William Christ, Katie, Tommy, Shelley, Robin, Ted Jarmal, Sherry Petrowski, and all those we hold in our hearts. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Awaken us, O God. Challenge and encourage your people to value the vocations to which each is called. We pray for all discerning new possibilities or changing employment.
In all our diverse callings, teach us to love our neighbor above all else.
Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Be our hope, O God. We remember with thanksgiving your disciples who died in faith, especially Betty Palm.
May their trust in your promise be our protection and our hope.
Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Remembering us according to your steadfast love as we offer these and the prayers of our heart, trusting in your compassion made known through Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
May the peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Thank you.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks. He broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, he gave thanks, and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Christ is dead. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Gathered into one, we are bold to pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Blessed be your name, merciful God, for gathered together in this place by your Spirit on this morning, we have feasted on your word, who is Christ Jesus. And this is the joy, and it is the delight of our hearts. We ask, gracious God, gather around your word, that we would be strengthened by all that we have seen and done here, that you would fill our lives with your Spirit, and that you would send us to use our hands to gather the world to your great banquet, so that none are left out and all are satisfied. We pray all of this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Thanks be to God.
So this is going to sound like it really is called a dismissal in here, but remember, we're doing God's work, our hands, today. So there's a few things on your way out. You can either do the shopping for the pantry or join us to make cards. We also have a Sunday school today to sign up for, so there's lots of things you can do. So it's a dismissal from this room, but not from God's presence. Go in peace. God is at work in your hands.
Thanks be to God.